So from years ago that when in Taiwan that nobody knows what bone marrow registry is, and all these years we have tried to promote the idea and trying to encourage more people to donate, and now like we have more and more people to have a positive response to that. So we hope that it will continue to gain momentum and So this is when she is 2015. There's another award that she won. She was nominated. So they were covering on the volunteers in South Africa, how they take care of the patients who diagnosed with HIV, and how they support each other despite their poverty. So at meanwhile, besides on doing online programs or radio program, she has her footprints in the prisoners and to promote the good idea and to trying to share her story and trying to direct people in the right directions. So she was invited to Hualien County's prisoner. So there are Mr. Zhang, he is the prisoner from the Hualien Correction Center. He has been listening to her program for over 10 years. A lot of them were actually touched by her story and learned that there's a possibility that they can have a better life and then walk on the correct path. So, this is recently when they have program covering this is when the back ancient time in Japan has sent delegations to China to learn about Buddhism. So there's a war about that historical event, and this is we think that it's important for us to talk about this and then to show people that how this is a positive influence in the society. So she's audience. She said that the Sister Meilan's lab is very memorable, very special. So they have nice staff from the radio stations talk, share about how they walk on this path, what story that touches them, and they're really grateful for the company all these years. So now that is for our bounce together, give a warm welcome to Sister Meilan. So the little poster they have is a humanistic culture mission of humanistic culture is spark of hope. So they were really grateful to have Sister Meilan to participate with us. Sister Meilan forgot to have people be exercise activities, so she skipped that part. So we will continue with that exercise portions after this assurance. So as Sister Meilan chair, you probably will move your body with her energy. That's what is her specialty. So, stand by Sister Mei Yun, the two are MC and host for the online show and the radio stations. So we're in Ciji, even though we all have different parts, we have different roles that we take. It's because Master Chen Yan that we are all connect together. And we have made it an environment when everybody here are happy and grateful. So the male volunteer is Brother Yongping. So we will hear their story later. So now let's give a warm welcome to Sister Meilan. She has amazing PowerPoint. So let's see.
不管是男性还是异性哦,
even though Master Chen Yan is not here with us, but for me, it's like having able to be here, it is a great traumatic affinity. We have so many friends and comrades to support us and then to walk with us. Doesn't despise it's an easy path or difficult path. We're always for each other. So, my name is Meilan, and I was very lucky when I was born. I have my own background music. So.
但是呢，曾经有人文置业非常非常资深的一位。
As I growing up, I realized how my parents, I appreciate my parents love me so much. So when we took refuge in Buddhahood in Ciji, so we have our Dharma name. So my name is Ci Ming. And then Ci Ming means that it's like a bird singing. So it's like bird singing. So there's another volunteer when she read her Dharma name, she stopped. She mistakenly to read the name as Crow. So it was actually kind of funny because those two words look pretty much the same. Anyway, so. So she said that the most important thing is, you know, to walk on Ciji path, you have to try to wake yourself up first, right? So before we trying to change other people, we're trying to help other people, we really need to learn how to save ourselves, how to improve ourselves first, right? So, I have been on board in Ciji radio stations since 1994, so it has been 30 years. So, when I first walked in for interviews, I was very excited because the team just asked me to on board like, immediately. So, well, so she graduated from the school, the graduate programs. She said that she finally understand why she graduated this year, because this is like an anniversary for her to celebrate her 30 years in working in Ciji radio station. So I have uphold my initial aspirations for over 30 years. I am not a superman, but we have a lot of ways in Ciji to make good connection with people. And then, we have many challenges, right? And so we also experienced that we have to digitalize And then one of the challenges is that I have to be an MC, and I have to be a DJ, and I have to be the director at the same time. So it's like everything, I have to learn everything, and I have to be able to work on everything. It's like, so when you able to do a lot of multitask, do a lot of things together, you're not necessarily just an octopus, you're like a 1,047. So for 30 years, you can see time leave them its mark on my on you. So the longer you volunteer in situ, you realize that you might be your face doesn't seem to age. So in the center pictures, this is what year was it? But it was like over 30 years old. So on the bottom right, it was in 2000. But the bottom left is in 2000. Bottom right is when she went to Guizhou, China, for disaster relief, and then she was still holding her kids. I just do a song and dance, and then. Number one. So in our central graduate school programs, it is good for people to study and then to learn something. So, you know, 30 years is a long time. It's a time that witness history, and also I'm writing my own history.
So,
the first day I was on board, We went on the street to canvassing. That was because in Tainan, there were Tainan County, there was a flood, so there were a lot of victims. And from the beginning, the first day of work, start working in the city, I've witnessed impermanence, I've witnessed things are fragile. And along the way, I have witnessed a lot of disasters that happened. And this is in 95, there is a steakhouse caught on fire that took 64 people's life. On the side, we have seen a lot of dead bodies laying on the floor. And then we have, and also at that time, it was a mid-autumn festival, so something similar to Thanksgiving holidays in the U.S. It's about the time when family get together. So you can imagine at the time that there are people, the victim's family are so desperate and so sad. And she was trying to comfort the mother who lost her child. The mother was really sad that her child was burned like a charcoal, and she was saying that how does that, like, I'm really sad that my kid is like burned like this, and then Sister Meilan was trying to comfort her by saying that, you know, Master Chen Yan has a lot of disciples in South Africa, they are all dark skin. So for your child, maybe in the future life, she will reincarnate in Africa. So will be a volunteer who will save a lot of lives. So that story had touched the mother, and then in a few years that she become volunteers. So this is picture that shows in 1996, there's a typhoon. There were a lot of people because they were like landslide, so a lot of people was trying to run and escape, and then so at a time when a lot of volunteers have begun to walk into the community, so they starting to help people with rebuilding their house and then to also to clean all the debris and everything. So, So there is a disciple has not been functioning with Tsuji for a long time, not on the table, but because when Tsuji had a restructures years ago, he was distributed to some group that he might not like, so he was kind of like hide away for a while. So they ended up when he heard Master Chen Yan is coming to the community, he immediately like wanted to come back. So that's how he. So this is about 9/21. Quake in Taiwan,
1992. This
is very touching.
He's
saying that
they were
so devastated and so scared with the earthquake. When they feel like aftershock, they get paranoid. They have all have PTSD, and it's really scary. And some of them are actually becoming suicidal. So this is something very serious. So when something like this happens, we need a professional to come to help. So we would tell people that when you try to comfort people, because you don't tell people, oh, stop crying, everything will get better, that kind of like phrases. And also don't argue with people, and then don't try too much to get in for their life. So this is like a video shows that how city volunteers in the severe deficit area, in the funeral home and in hospital to care for the victim and then their families. So she's saying like this whole family, when sister and brother-in-law would die, and then their children, the older ones all passed away, and there's only one left was like not even 10 years old, and she was trying to hold it back so that she doesn't cry in front of other victims. So Master Chen Yan is to encourage her that, you know, we have to calm ourselves down, we don't want to hold on to all the suffering, and learn to switch to change your mindset, and then to adjust yourself, and then don't bring more sorrow to children. And we can try chanting Buddha's name. So it will like make her child cry more, but it's okay. Let them cry, let them release the negative energies. We can comfort them with body gestures, and then with a heart to comfort. So this is really troubling time. I also feel that my heart is emptied out. So we all know that everybody must just feel the same way. So for us, the most important thing is to calm ourselves down, to collect ourselves, to really make effort to complete the relief missions. Because if we like drown in our sorrows, who is gonna save those? Who is gonna take care of those victims, right? So we have to learn how to in the peaceful time, we have to carry ourselves in with impressions. When disaster happens, we need to have a calm mind to guide our compassion, to care for those who need help. So in her careers in the radio station, her main goal is to do lives like through touching story, the real story, to make comforting and healing of them on the audience. So she has collected a lot of stories, and then she was trying to be encouraging to those who were listening to her story. So at the time, it was really, really difficult, right? And sometimes it's difficult to interview those interviewees, and sometimes it's there are other like obstacles she has to overcome. And she said that there are times she wanted to give up, but she said she can't, because she feels that she has a responsibility when she has already interviewed people, that she needs to like release all the story. So why do you think Siji is as a group, right? So we are not just a... Imagine just like a normal group, like we work together. And then she mentioned that there was like a Korean pop group. Their costume, stage costume, looks very much similar to Tsuji's uniform, you know, the white pants and blue shirts. So that was a very interesting, like how that was a coincidence. This is her.
He
met her husband in Tsuji. So this is when he went back to Hualien to help establishing the Hualien middle school.
Yeah.
So people thought that, you know, he joined Siji because of her. She said no, she joined Siji before he met me. So it's not like the common story of how wife brought the husband in, that kind of story. So,
为什么是我自己指定呢? 因为那一天是慈中金社路跑, 上人一定会在家, 所以因缘很好, 就慈中全校的学生,
So they met in Hualien, Jingshihou, and that was a really good karma
affinity.
So it was
对啊，然后嘉轩姐姐是下午帮我们主持默契。
So that was a event for it's kind of like a marathon.
那时候就闹苦呀。哦，真的很感恩呐，因为在
书写自己的见证历史
的时候，也书写自己的生命历史，所以呢。
To wait for Master Chen Yan.
So
they were. So they ended up having like successful match like six couples on that day. So it was kind of cute. So she also wrote a book about her life, about her journey in city, and how she invited her family and then to.And then build a Bodhisattva family. So, her children were like their education went through like all the city system except the university because the subject they want to study was not, they don't have a program in city university. So, they were both in Taipei for school.
在慈济有好多，那现在他们已经念大学了，所以呢，我们金社就是过年行堂，我们都全家一起去。
So when her
六个，我们全家，因为还有表姐跟姐姐这样子。然后呢，今年
So her birth son was born on the same day when Master Chen Yan was visiting
金社行堂
Indian Hospital.So, the first day he was born, he was Master Chen Yan, so that was really a great comedic benefit. So, her son has been inviting his classmate to Hualien, Qingzi Abode, to serve food in the dining hall. So, we are very grateful for welcoming new life in our family and also saying farewell to loved one. And she said that because her mother-in-law had dementia. And it's very difficult because, you know, like when you have a dementia person in the house, it's really things goes off the ground, and there have been a long time that she can't really sleep, and because the mother-in-law was so afraid that she would be sent to a nursing home, so she basically wouldn't let the family go to sleep. So she said that when you sleep deprived, you don't have like good temper. So the way she deal with that is to listening to Master's teaching. So that will calm her down, and then to reprogram her mind. So when she was taking care of her mother was there to help her. Originally, was help her to taking care of her son. And all of a sudden, that the mother-in-law was come down with dementia. So the mother was actually helping to take care of the in-laws and also the children. So when the mother finally had to go back to her home, Sister Meilan finally felt a lot of stress. Right? So she said that it was time when she finally had like negative emotions because it was so difficult to take care of so many people. So difficult to take care of so many people at the time. She learned that through the years, she learned that how the mother-in-law's condition is really something that it's like her mentor in the spiritual cultivations. Because the mother-in-law might become a very difficult person because of dementia. But that was helping her to really implement Buddhist Dharma into her life, to really, really help her to develop a true heart of patience and compassion. So she learned to appreciate that all the obstacles, all the difficulties in her life. So, and she knows that how the way she take care of her elders, it will directly influence how their children take care of her. It was difficult to take care of a person with dementia. So the mother-in-law would like to throw her food around and to throw her feces around and then to just make a huge mess in the house. She realized that this is truly test for her, because she also discovered that she has a temper, even despite in Fontaine City for over 10 years. So she has to, every day is like a roller coaster for her. She was trying to change her mindset. It took her 4 years to really turn her mind around, to really understand that no matter how difficult life is going to be, and how bad her mother-in-law's condition become, it was all part of the spiritual cultivation training that she has to endure. Both her in-law and her own mother were passed away sitting on a chair. So they were actually both very left very peacefully. He has learned been doing disaster relief for 30 years. So when her son called her saying that grandma has passed out on a chair, her first reaction was not directing the sons to call ambulance. She was like, call your father. So it's like, even she said that a lot of time in the time of crisis, you would turn back to the original self. You might throw away all your training. So that's what happened to her. She was really, really grateful that her mother became a silent mentor, which is body donor for the medical students. So she was really grateful that her mother and her mother-in-law are the two really big pusher in her spiritual cultivation path. It's really, really, she cannot accomplish a lot of good characteristics without the mother's help and the mother's guidance. So he said that has really two things that we cannot wait. One is feel piety, and one is show compassion to your fellow community. So we have to So she is trying really hard to always invite people to listen to Master's teaching, because this all the teachings are so valuable for us. So I don't have a lot of time. So I can't, I just, I can't play a video. So, but hopefully next time we'll do it. So here is a
那也都有,
you can actually scan a QR code to follow her radio stations if you understand Chinese.
除了可以加 LINE 的好友, 就是这个是广播,
so they have been, there has been a restructure in Dai TV station. So they have been regrouped to combine with program team. So this is for radio stations line group. You can add. So this is a
所以呢，这个是志为人医守护爱。
Wow, what is this?
那如果你直接, 在网络上你就打,
So the podcast has been using small story, kind of like short clip video. So they have like short clip, one after the other. So it's easier for people to learn about how to take care of themselves. So you can search for Firefly's Journey. You have to type in Chinese to look for it. So this podcast program is to help people to promote like healthy way of life to people, and then to make people aware that if you want to help others, you have to really care for yourself first.
就是我们的生活让大家可以一起来让自己的身体。So
there's some programs in city that is really good because it has like medical information. They have some like a lot of correct tips like usually people don't know. So this is something that they really wanted to promote to people. So maybe some of those videos that you will save a life when you share. So we're grateful. So say, don't you feel that when you listening to Sister Meilan's sharing, that you her energy will just make you want to pause for her and then to move her.
We're
talking about this TV series about dementia. And then, she said that like, the TV series is content, probably the story doesn't, it's probably not as intense as what happened to your home, right?
Yeah.
So there's a So today we're talking about the 921 earthquake. Looking back, when that first happened in the morning, most of everyone is crying. Everybody was shocked. Everybody, almost nobody knows what's going to happen. It was so devastating for people. And for volunteers, feedback sharing is that thank you for, because you were sharing that we have seen a good example of utilize both wisdom and compassion and how to develop them both and what would person look like with that both. So we're really grateful for her to be able to share in a very calm manner, but also very energetic one. So
那这边杨云倩他说极其精彩，泰国慈济人都是菩萨才女，秋玉师姐哈，这边他有写到你，不过因为时间因缘的一个关系
she said, the volunteer was commenting on
好这边哈，
好
热络，我们。
It is very shocking that to see how Sister Meilan has her has not, doesn't seem that she has been aged, and it was very it's very amazing.
大家幸福吗？哇，太好了！那今天就带来这一首《幸福百分百》。
So we have to that our activities group to lead the exercise. So you have to look at it. All their costumes are found through the recycling stations. So they will recycle the clothes. So.This is today's song is called Happy Life 100%. So, if you want, you can stand up and then to follow their move. They're arranging the stage.So, everybody, let's go. We are all like happy alchemists.
How? It is inevitable that things will go wrong in life. Hands are empty. You call this karate. This is all right for us to practice kung fu. Life is inevitably in gym and lackings. In others, have.Difficulties. You said we must do it together because we have good kung fu. If it rains heavily outside the house, inside will be wet and dewy. You say that the tingling just like playing the drums. We could just like the choir singing in harmony. Others complain things are not satisfied, actually only being a fool to look for troubles.You said you must have happiness so that your life will be happy and joyful. If running into hardship, we should take it as happiness and enjoyment. You say you have good karate skill. You will have the chance to show it out. Sure, have something for nothing. We had to find...Solutions for everything. We are happiness magician. Change. The sour will become sweet. The bitterness will be gone. When encounter dissatisfaction, we will change it into interesting. Check.